Shoulder dislocation is a very common problem, especially in young people, usually between 15 to 40 years age group. As such, shoulder is a kind of ball and socket joint. If you see here, this is the structure of the shoulder. You see, this is the shoulder blade and this is the ball. And this ball and socket, especially the socket in shoulder, is not like hip joint, where this is a deep cup, but here in the shoulder, it's a flat bone actually. So the ball moves on this flat bone, and that's how we get movements in the shoulder. But sometimes what it can happen so that the ball can come out of the socket. Usually in shoulder, there is a protective mechanism, like what we call as a capsule around this shoulder. You see this brown structure? This is called capsule and labrum. And this capsule and labrum will keep the ball in position. That means you'll get movements, but the ball won't come out of the socket. But due to many times, due to injuries, accidents, or falls, or sometimes due to sports injuries, you can have a tear in this capsule or labrum so that there is no restraint to the ball and the ball can come out of the joint. And this will give you sudden onset of severe pain in the shoulder, and the person cannot lift the shoulder because there's no joint. The ball has come out of the socket, so the joint doesn't exist, and there will be deformity. You will see that the shoulder shape has changed, and you cannot lift the shoulder, and you will have severe pain. And this is what we call acute shoulder dislocation, number one. And the treatment for this is usually to put it back, to keep the ball inside the socket again. So most of the times, this can be done in a hospital setup by a doctor, especially a trained orthopedic surgeon. I mean, sometimes a physician can also put it back. And sometimes it can be done without anesthesia, but most of the times when the patient has a lot of pain and he cannot tolerate pain, usually we give some short minor anesthesia and then we'll put the shoulder back. We call it as reduction under anesthesia. And this is a simple procedure, it takes just 2 minutes. And once the ball goes into the joint, you'll get pain relief and you'll be comfortable and the shape of the shoulder returns to normal. And usually after this kind of episode, we'll usually give a kind of bag to give you rest and also for the tissues to heal inside the joint. And usually the resting period is for 2 to 3 weeks, and after 2 to 3 weeks you can remove the bag and start moving the shoulder. And this is for people who had dislocation for the first time. But somebody dislocating often, that means somebody dislocates twice, thrice, or 10 times, there are patients who dislocate for 50 times, 100 times also. Some dislocate every day. So this is different. This is what we call recurrent dislocation. That means in these patients, the tissues are damaged so badly that they cannot prevent further dislocation of the ball. So these are the patients who require some kind of treatment, and most of these patients will require some kind of surgery. And in these days, we can do a simple endoscopic surgery, what we call arthroscopy. It's a keyhole surgery with which we can repair the damaged tissues and make the shoulder stable again. So those who dislocate more than once, that means more than two times, will require some kind of treatment, and they cannot just neglect it. Because we do see so many patients who come to me after like 10 times dislocation or 50 times dislocation, 100 times dislocation, which is not good, because the more number of times you dislocate, there will be more damage to the joint, because every time you dislocate, the bones rub against each other and there will be some damage to the bones also. Thank you.